Never forget the frame five, man. Never forget. And frame five, we trust, man. So now we got Texas A&M versus UNT.
UNT.
So A&M coming in with
Profit.
Pika.
A&M coming in with Pika?
Yep.
Pika?
Pika?
And against Profit, I don't like this matchup as Captain Falcon, although
sounds awful.
I don't like most matchups with Falcon, but I think that Falcon does have some tools, and I think as long as Profit keeps up airing, which normally he should as a Falcon player, he should be fine.
I had the pleasure of hanging out with Esam the other weekend, getting to pick his brain about stuff with Pikachu. He thinks this is one of Pikachu's best matchups, so this is going to be rough, especially, oh wow, Pika going in.
Yeah, it's, I think that if you have a Falcon player in a crew battle, they should never go first because it's probable that you're going to get, yeah, it's very volatile.
You don't put Falcon, you don't put Little Mac.
You should save it for a character that Falcon will do well against. But
yes,
we'll see if Profit can get some of that style. He comes right in with that down air, going for a very high knee, maybe trying to catch Pika coming in with an aerial. Waiting for the roll in, and he gets it, but on the shield.
Not much damage, and he ends up getting a grab and getting more damage back. Ooh. That dare is not safe on shield, man. Mm-mm. Not in this game.
But a dare on forward smashes.
Side dare, dude. Ooh. That was the good hit that he needed.
Yeah.
That was the non-techable one.
Oh, that jab, with that jab, yeah. So Profit, wow, okay, both forward smashing. That was like the streams colliding. Oh, wow.
That would have been sick if you got like a
knee
out of that.
Yeah.
Knee, uppie, whatever, man.
Up-B?
More hits. Yeah, dude, Falcon dive. Always Falcon dive. Like a man.
Profit will actually, if you start off a game with him with something very predictable like Cloud Charging Limit, he will actually just run up to you and up B.
Well, yeah, because your first reaction is shield. Mm-hmm. Oh, man. He could go in deep for that edge guard.
It's reasonable to do against Falcon. Pikachu has a good recovery, and Falcon has a poor one. And Profit really eating for these down smashes. Gets the down air, but
up
can't
air.
Connect that up air high enough to kill.
Joke's on you. We patched that. I miss down air, up air doing a little bit more damage.
I miss it being an absolute confirm from down throw. Because back then, down throw was a confirm into knee.
Yeah, but knee was bad. The percent that it worked, it wasn't good enough.
That's fair.
Talking about this game, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank God. I was making sure. I was like, wait a minute.
Interesting. All right.
I mean, I guess he didn't expect that.
Yeah, I mean, probably was DIing out thinking he wouldn't die, I guess.
Maybe it's because he caught him so fast because he rolled back and was holding that way still.
Okay.
I'm giving the benefit of the doubt. Accident. Misinput. Yeah.
Back air.
Hey, Profit. So, Profit's got guts, man. He's not afraid.
That is his entire thing. One thing I'd like to see him do more, which he doesn't do often, is I'd like to see him do a drop jump and then do a knee or a down air.
Oh, yeah. Like go ledge and just pop up with an aerial?
Yeah, yeah. I call it drop jump. I don't know what to call it. When you press down and X at the same time to pop up above the ledge, I call that a drop jump.
I mean, I know what you mean. That's all that matters.
Yeah. He doesn't incorporate that a lot, and I think he should because that's very stylish, and that's exactly what Profit wants all the time.
Oh,
yeah,
no.
So what he was going to do there was he was going to up air the jabbing, but couldn't find it. Up smash.
I do run up smash to punish stuff. It's,
yeah.
It combos. It's nice.
Do you play Falcon?
I do sometimes.
Good.
I play when I'm not playing Charizard, I play Falcon.
Okay.
I play Falcon in every game, man.
That's good. I do too.
The
except in melee because it's really hard in melee.
You'll learn.
Ooh, trying to read a roll, but instead only getting a dash in from Profit.
This is really close. I'm liking this.
Yeah. It's like I said, Falcon can do some things to Pikachu, like, for example, kill very early.
Give him the hug. Shouts to Huggies,
dude. This is going to be the worst joke I've ever made, but if you get an up B with Falcon or Ganondorf, do you have to say no homo?
Oh my gosh.
By the way, full disclosure, I'm super homo, so that doesn't. It's just a joke.
It's a joke, man.
Yeah. It's just a joke. It's a prank, bro.
Just a prank.
Oh, that's he needs to stop doing these thunders in the air because eventually Profit's going to punish that with a knee.
Oh, I like that re-grab. Not much out of it. And he faded back to avoid the up smash. Profit's got some download going on
now. Yeah, Profit, once you realize that you don't have to be overwhelmed by Pikachu all the time with Falcon, it's actually pretty easy to deal with. I actually do this matchup myself, even though I also play Corrin because it's important for Corrin.
What? So good for Corrin.
I don't like it. Ooh, going for the F smash. He could have died there. And he keeps down airing him after these thunders, and it's doing so much damage.
It is, and it's, oh,
and the SD.
No. And Profit getting the clean two-stock lead for his crew. That's important.
Very important.
That's so good out the gate.
And with Captain Falcon against Pikachu.
You know what?
His blood is pumping. He is heated up right now.
If he gets burned on the switch, though, it's not that big of a deal because he just took out their starter. He's looking pretty fresh.
Yeah.
He looks like a pretty solid
and
player on the team.
And now counterpick advantage for UNT.
Yep.
To start.
Meanwhile, on the melee stream, I see Wobbly.
What else would you expect? The guy's name is Wobbs.
That's not Wobbs.
Oh. I can't read.
I don't think that's Wobbs.
I don't know. Well, because Ham Yojo's playing Sheik.
It says that.
So that is Wobbs.
Is that Hamlin, though?
Yeah.
Whatever. Well, back to this stream.
Would Hamlin be playing Ice Climbers?
No, I don't think he's playing at all.
It says Ham Yojo, though.
But it doesn't mean it's him. I don't see his face.
I don't know melee players here. I only know Malph.
Because he's the best.
Well, and Wobbles, but he's kind of like Neo Dallas. He like almost doesn't count in a way.
Yeah. I've had that argument before. Someone else forgot to tell Billy his tag. He runs over.
Hey, can you put like a tilde in there as well?
can you put like seven X's after?
XX, no scope. Something. Gavin!
MLG Master. Gavin? Sitting
oh,
down.
I know Gavin.
You know Gavin?
Yeah, he came to Shockwave quite a few times back before he went to college.
All right.
Very famous in my mind for literally always playing the number one seed the first time
that
in
is
first round. He like almost always got seeded 32nd.
Unfortunate for Gavin.
I think there were like 6 weeks in a row where he played Denti round one. I was like, dude, are you okay? And he was like, not really.
Shouts to Gavin, dude.
Yeah.
Because
Gavin's super cool.
He kept coming back after 6 weeks and didn't complain to the TO. That's the kind of.
He might have.
I mean, it took 6 weeks for it to change, so I don't think he did.
So, Gavin.
Wait.
Extra hour of sleep!
It's daylight savings time?
Dude, I'd like to imagine that,
oh
like...
Oh my gosh, it's fall.
I'd like to imagine that Ben Franklin came into work an hour late one day, and his boss was like, why are you an hour late? And, it, like, he's about to invent daylight savings time, and he just goes, oh, you haven't heard? We all turn our clocks back an hour.
You do know the real reason, right?
No.
Farming. You turn it back an hour so you get more sunlight time.
I'm just saying I'd like to imagine. I like the way that Profit SDs, by the way.
Jumps off, Falcon punches into Falcon kick.
Yeah. And then the second time he does two Falcon kicks. So I haven't seen Gavin play in a long time, but I do know that when I played him, he did kind of struggle with the Falcon matchup against Ness. Falcon, because I think the real reason is that Nesses are mostly very air dodge happy, and I think that Falcon is probably the best character in this game on capitalizing off of reading air dodges.
Yeah, you can shark really well just because you're so fast. You have fast and fast aerial moves.
And
really
also very powerful aerial moves, such as forward air, as I say it. It's like Bloody Mary, you say it three times.
I love the knee, but in this game, I just don't.
It's so powerful, though.
I mean, yeah, we have to land it.
Oh, he techs it.
You're right, dude. Profit knows. He got. Was that a trade? Did he trade damage on that? I think they traded damage.
Oop, Danny did not tech it that time.
He got pushed into the untechable, I think.
Yeah.
That or there's way too much hitstun to get
tech. Profit probably shouldn't try to edgeguard that anymore.
No.
It would look super cool, but maybe not in a crew battle. All right.
I like Profit, man. He goes in.
I mean, no, he's super cool. But
he lives and dies by the Falcon.
Oh, is he going to go for the down air? He does not. Wow. And Gavin going to make it back. That time, Profit trying to down tilt the recovery instead.
All right, he's about to get forward air to oblivion.
Ooh, Gavin going for that PK Thunder Mix. Oh! The charged F smash.
He buffered the spot dodge, and he was stuck.
I think that deserved to show me your moves.
That did.
But Profit too nice.
No time.
Ooh.
He teched that. Why
good
not?
Recovery.
Why not? Let's just. Oh no!
But don't tech that. Ooh! Woo-hoo! Profit will do that. Profit.
Oh man!
Went for it one more time. He will do that. Profit will kill you with that.
I'll say this right now: Profit is probably not the person you should have in a crew battle.
Yeah.
But man, I want to see him play some singles.
Well, guess what? He made it out of pools, so tomorrow we will be seeing some of that.
Sweet. I'm down.
At least I think he did. Pretty sure he did.
If he didn't, I'd be disappointed. I don't know who that that bearded man is, but shout-outs to him.
Who?
Jumping up on the stage, asking Gavin a question, and jumping off the stage.
He's asking Gavin, hey, how are you going to deal with Critter? How are you going to even do that, bro?
I mean, even though Ike is a slower sword character,
Ness is still a sword character.
Ness has a hard time. Especially since Ike can just kind of jump back in air, jump back forward air, jump back air.
Jump back in air to... Oh, wow, I just hurt my hand. You can do jump back in air to up tilt to forward air.
Oh, yeah, especially if you do the reverse like back hit of Nair and it pops them up perfectly and you just get free moves after.
That is, I think, honestly, one of the best combo starters that isn't a throw in this game.
Yeah, for sure. It's harder to land, but you get rewarded for it amazingly.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Gavin just going straight off the stage, being like, I don't need that. Let's go.
2-1, and start. Okay, so these two, I'm expecting Gavin to do well in the early game, but once it gets into the later game when he has trouble killing Critter, that's when Critter's really going to shine.
Oh, yeah, he's going to need to find a way to get stocks out at a more decent pace, because if he lets him get to like 120, that rage is way too dangerous to deal with, especially his character is Ness. Like, oof, it's going to be a rough time.
Yeah.
Because that disjoint's going to beat out the uppie, isn't it?
Might, yeah.
I think it's got potential. I don't really see this matchup ever. That was nice. Go, Critter.
Ooh. Critter going for that ledge cancel on the side B, but just missing it.
All right, up throw.
Up throw to forward air, yep. That is, forward air is such a kill move later on. Maybe not on Battlefield, but is definitely a killer move. Tried to wait for the air dodge, but Ness has quite a good one in his ranks.
See, I think this is an issue with mid-level players, is the air dodge way too much, man. Like, no air dodge. If he had Nair would have got him out of that situation, maybe he got him into a free combo.
Yeah.
But it's okay. Gets back on the stage.
Gavin is doing a really good job of recovering, though. And that time, Gavin thought he could air dodge because Critter would only go for the forward air combo, but instead, he got hit with that read on the air dodge with the up air.
Yep. Get in with that mix-up. Rip Gavin's second stock. All right. Jab
on
combo.
His last one. Ooh. Critter going for that forward tilt, which would have set up an up B situation, which Critter can counter and will counter.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Sword characters have counters, and that beats up B.
This trophy rush music is a little unfitting for a crew battle.
I like trophy. Yeah, it's fine, yeah. No, you really need to go through your list, at least for a stream setup. In the future, I'll remember this, and next time I'm at, we do crews. We gotta change the music.
Just don't, like, Trophy Rush is just.
Well, I mean,
it sounds like a movie adaptation of a Dr. Seuss book.
I hate when you go on to Smashville and you get like two the song like 2 a.m. or whatever.
Oh, I love 2 a.m.
That's so slow.
You're thinking of
you're thinking of
The Roost.
The Roost. That's just
our good friend JV really hates that song.
Yes, he does.
Like, he had a time where he would just not commentate a match when that song was playing. He's like, this boring music does not deserve my great commentary, and it was awesome.
That was so funny.
All right.
Justin, the most humble man I know. Oh, man. Critter. Oh,
ooh, back throw will do it. Gavin will take a stock from Critter.
All right, Gavin. You're not going out that easy. Now let's go one more. Down air. Down air. Never a down air. That's good enough.
But Critter will recover. Not enough time to jump down and do a counter on that recovery. And now I don't think really expecting that one. Forward tilt, not going to be enough, but will he counter now? He was going to, but he missed his opportunity.
He got hit by the Thunder Tail. It's difficult to
do.
Especially that close.
Mm-hmm.
Ness going with that big forehead of his. Oh, man.
Yeah, Gavin had the platform above him, so he wasn't able to get the PK Thunder 2, and Critter taking that stock.
Let's go. Dash attack. Easy.
I would do that, but my wrist hurts.
Are you okay?
It was fine. I've had a torn tendon.
Oh.
And I've had a wrist brace on all day, but it was feeling fine, so I took it off, and now it's not fine.
That was a bad idea.
It was a bad idea.
Do you need assistance? Should we go get, like, the wrist brace somewhere?
Huh?
Is the wrist brace somewhere nearby?
It's in my car. I'll be fine.
Okay.
I'll have it later. I go to see an orthopedist on Tuesday.
All right. Well, Aquapod commentating through the pain.
If you just hear me at any point, just go, ah! It's probably because I modulated my wrist in an uncomfortable way.
That is super, super unfortunate.
It's very unfortunate.
You're still here repping your boys, watching them do their thing.
Doing their thing and talking about them doing their thing.
The two great things you can do.
That's all I'm here for. I think my entire purpose in life is to talk about stuff and make a living out of it.
That's called a storyteller.
A voice user, if you would.
A voice user.
That used to be my tag for everything until I was like, voice user doesn't really flow well.
What is an Aquapod?
It's complete nonsense.
Okay.
And it happened in a dream.
Oh my gosh.
Where my sister thought for some reason that the letter M was pronounced Aquapod.
Doesn't make any sense.
Doesn't, but it's a dream. Nothing in dreams makes sense.
That's not true. I've had pretty normal dreams.
Okay, well, you're normal. I guess I'm having dreams about the letter M being pronounced Aquapod for no reason.
Wait, does your first name start with M?
No.
What, so you just went with Aquapod, because why not?
I just went with Aquapod because I thought it was funny, and it's unique. If you look up Aquapod, you find me.
That's fair. I mean, I'm rice, so people find all kinds of stuff. Bowls of rice.
Bowls
long
of rice,
grain rice.
Rice balls.
Basmati rice. Jasmine rice.
Jelly donuts.
Jelly. You're right. Jelly donuts from Pokemon.
Nothing beats a jelly-filled donut.
Never forget. Four kids. Why you do this?
I love Four Kids dub so much. The only good Four Kids dub that actually existed, and it's because they only did like five episodes of it, was the F-Zero anime.
They did the whole series.
I know, the F-Zero anime is...
But is it short?
It's 51 episodes.
Oh, yeah. I thought they did the whole thing. Dubbed it. Or maybe they only did,
No, Four Kids only did five episodes.
No way.
They did five episodes.
Oh, it crashed that badly? Do you know why they did that in the first place? Do you want to know the funny thing that happened?
What's the funny thing that happened?
So, back when I was a kid, and we had Foxbox. Mm-hmm. Shouts to Fox. On Foxbox, they ran a thing, like a promotion. And it was, you go online to like Foxbox.com and you would vote for your favorite Smash Brothers character, and they would find a TV, they would bring you a TV show for it, and that was Captain Falcon 1.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, dude, it was cool. It was super cool.
And I'm so glad, because that is my second favorite anime of all time. Granted, I've only watched four, but it is my second favorite anime of all time. The other one is also about racing, but I'll get into that later. We're talking about Smash
Initial
right
D?
Now. Huh?
Initial D?
Heck yeah!
All right.
Definitely.
Sorry,
Initial
headphone
D.
Users.
Dude, I'm going to shout about Initial D all day.
All right, we'll talk about it later.
All right.
So we got Ike and Roy.
Yeah.
The Lords. Is Ike a Lord? Ike's a Lord, right? I don't remember.
I didn't play
any of his games. He's a mercenary, but I don't know if his class is Lord or whatnot.
No, I don't think he is.
Okay.
I think he's actually one of the few that isn't a Lord.
Maybe.
But Fritter should have at least a little bit of matchup knowledge, as we did have Cethlon playing Smash 4 for a solid 8 or 9 months. And Cethlon, of course, did play Roy in this game, as he does in every other.
And he was a champ, because Roy has a real bad recovery. Mm-hmm. You get beat by just about everything when you try to up B.
Except for at the very start, but only at the very start.
Not in the air.
Oh, that's right, not in the air.
Not in the air.
You're right.
No armor in the air.
You're right.
It's quite a sad life.
Rest in peace, Roy.
Rest in peace, Roy. He's about to get ripped on right now.
Ooh, yeah, rip indeed. Counter. Ooh. That'll be it. That's the experience in the matchup coming in right there. He saw exactly where Roy was, and he said, you're going to recover now. I'm going to counter. I counter with counter. All right, trying to get the setup with that neutral air, but pretty weak.
All right, get some of that in there. All right, here we go. Double-edged dance. Getting that free damage. And the jab combos come back. Dude, Roy is one of the few characters that does not have a multi-jab. He just has a jab.
Yeah, just a jab.
Like Ganon's.
All yeah, right, down both quite good. Wow, spot dodging the F smash. That was ballsy.
Dude, it'd been sick if he countered it, though. Let's be real. I want to see more counters in this matchup, because when I see two characters with a counter, that's all I want.
Counters are so hype, dude. And they're so demoralizing when you get hit with one, too. You're like, oh, no, they knew.
Especially if you're ahead, too. Like,
yeah.
Ooh, it crushes your soul.
The worst, and I can attest to this as a Korin player, the worst is a Korin counter, on something that's really weak. Because sometimes I'll have times where I'll counter something as Corn and it kills somebody, and I'll be like, yeah, I probably shouldn't have killed off of one hit of Fox's forward air at like 60. That probably shouldn't have happened.
Were you up near the blast zone at least?
Sometimes.
I hope so. Oh, there it is. Forward tilt.
Forward tilt.
Forward tilt kills, dude. It's a very strong move.
It's basically just a mini F smash.
Yep. It's faster. It's not as strong, but it's faster and has way less recovery.
Yeah. So now Critter on his last stock. He's got to try to not get too much damage built up on him before he can find his up throw to up air.
Oh, there it is. But he's going to live. Smashville.
He tried to wait for the air dodge, but Zanuck just did nothing, so he said, I guess I'll still up air.
I think he was about to try to start it. He didn't want to go for a late one. I respect Ooh. That.
Tried to get the down air on that up B, actually.
Oh, man. Oh, the Critter, not frame five.
Yeah, Critter falling apart a little bit, actually.
I think Chris is gonna be able to take out the stock before before he goes out. He might even be able to take the second one because Ike with Rage, man.
Ike with Rage, yeah, it does get that back air right there. And the balloon!
That's all
Let's
you need,
go, Critter.
Dude, UNT up in the balloon battles. Let's go.
We have a couple balloons now, yeah.
A couple balloons.
Ooh. Oh.
He's fine. Going under the stay.
Oh no! Smashville pushed him too far.
Critter just turned and shook the dude's hand. He's like, my bad. Just walks off.
Yep.
Oh,
so
man.
Now,
that was ridiculous. That was such a... I've not actually seen that, like, do that.
It, like, yeah, I've never seen it just push you too far to grab the ledge. That's weird. So, Murr will be coming in next, it looks like. I could see by this sweet leather jacket. I think Murr's goal is to take that last stock. You can see Disco Bunny with his crazy backpack chilling out on the stage.
Shout outs
to Disco, dude.
He's cool. He's cool, dude.
It is such a joy to exist in his general vicinity.
He's funny. He's so
such a cool guy.
All right,
Murr.
Coming out.
That's still not enough R's.
I think I'm saying it like Burr, and I think that's where my the lack of power in it's coming from when I say his name.
Murr!
Kind of sound like a pirate at that point, though.
He won our the last Arcadian we had, which was a while ago.
Like UNT?
UNT
like...
Arcadian,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And he, so we write down who's banned from the Arcadian, and
who
on our sheet of, on our sheet of paper, who is banned from the Arcadian. We just had ours go all the way around the sheet and all the way into the middle and all the way around again.
Oh, my gosh.
Because he wants as many as he can. Who's
That's
banned?
So much
Dakpo, Denti, Murr, and Critter, I think, are banned.
Nice.
And then probably Jace as well, although I don't remember.
My boy Prophet's going to be banned soon, though.
Oh, Prophet is banned, too. Like I said, I haven't been around a lot.
Yeah, you're right.
So this is going to be a little tough for Murr, just for the fact that Roy has... big disjoint.
Yeah,
that's going to be his biggest problem.
Mario is just going to drop down Nair and trade, so.
That's fair. Actually, that's Nair, but, you know. Come
on. Puns so
jokes.
Much. I hate puns so much.
Oh, God. Well, we're not going to go
Have you ever commentated with Infinity?
Oh, dude, I want to.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Oh, man, you're a pun lover, aren't you?
Oh,
you're one
I
of them.
Love puns so much.
Oh, jeez. No puns here. No puns allowed. Actually, I think they're still. I think they took away the pun alert emote. So thank you, T-Log.
Yeah.
Thank you, Billy.
Well, that's because Infinity's not commentating. He could have gotten another up air right there.
He could have,
yeah.
Or a back air possibly.
Ooh, I thought he was gonna go for a forward air.
He's got a lot of percent down now. Just send him off stage, edge guard him. He's rolling,
Ooh,
man.
Ooh, just in time to shield that. He needs to charge that flood.
He needs to back throw actually.
Yeah.
Now he needs to just run off and trade. If you lose this dog, it's whatever, man.
Yeah. Because your team's already ahead. You might as well. Ooh, caught him.
Oh, man.
But charged the flood.
Instead of flooding, that would have been a really entertaining stock. He needs to run around up smash. Come on.
Yeah.
Does he Mario? Come on. No, it's not an up smash.
That's back throw.
That was
Won't
a free
kill.
Up smash. That was a free up smash.
That's sometimes you just get a little scared of losing that stock, though.
You're playing against Roy. You should be afraid at all times. Up smash
Ooh.
Anyways.
That's not frame five.
That's not frame five. Roll up smash.
Actually, what frame is Mario's down smash?
I have no idea. It might be frame five. I could be wrong.
It really could be. And down air, a weak kill move, but it is a kill move. And there it is, my favorite pose in the game. My second favorite pose of the game is Mario doing that. My favorite is in the middle of Robin's taunt, and he just looks like he's shrugging.
I'm happy he got that kill, because he was at, like, 160, so I would have been upset.
Yeah. Downer surprisingly kills.
With, like, 100. He's at 100. He had all that rage. Come on. Let's get those stocks. But he's easy there. Now it's 9-6?
9-6, yeah. UNT would still have Murr, Denti, and Jace.
Meanwhile, A&M has Mexichu, I believe. Unless he sat out. I actually don't know.
They also have, like, 7 Domino's pizzas. I just want to point that out. They got, like, 7 pizzas.
Oh, okay. This is Texan Sniper.
Texan Sniper. Okay, he's a another regular at the Tourney Locator Shockwaves. Or at least he used to be. I don't know if he is now.
I mean,
he is during the summer, at least.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it sounds like a long drive, because the call station is like 3 hours?
Yeah, but he, at least during the summer, he is.
Down smash is actually frame 5 for Mario.
Oh my goodness! Frame 5! Let's go!
Wait, I think it might be 2 frame 5, dude. Hold on.
Dude, I'm gonna bring that back to UNT.
No, second hit's frame 14, so.
Okay.
But it's frame 5. It's frame 5, man. That's how you know it's a good move.
2.8 frame 5?
2.8 frame 5. Is that how that math works?
Yeah, because 5, 10, and then...
Oh, you're right. No,
yeah,
I get you.
4/5 is the same thing as 8/10.
Man, are you? Please tell me you're a math major.
No, I'm a theater major.
Change.
No, dude, that sounds miserable.
Ah, math majors are, I'm taking some of the funnest people I know.
I'm taking math 1580, and I'm like, ugh.
Okay, so Texas Sniper.
Apportionment methods.
Also plays Green Pit.
Green Pit? Frame 5!
Do we have to say... They both have frame 5.
They both have frame 5.
Even matchup. Even matchup.
Yeah.
Frame 5's let's
frame
go.
Frame 5. Dude, this is the best day of my life.
I'd be sad if Texan Sniper doesn't down smash a bunch.
Oh, dude, he's got to after seeing the legend of the frame 5 in the last battle.
Yeah, dude, leave the legendary frame 5 master.
All right, here we go. So, Murr has 3 stocks. Texan Sniper has 3 stocks.
Yep.
This is an even game between the two.
And they both have frame 5s, so it's anyone's game, really.
So one disadvantage that Mario has is that Texan Sniper will be able to easily jump out of the up tilts.
Because he's got 3-year-old jumps. 3-year-old jumps?
Got many. 3 or 4.
We'll see.
Yeah, let's
hope he SDs. That's 4.
Let's not hope he SDs. How about that? Let's hope nobody SDs.
What? It's not a crew battle if no one SDs, Alcapod.
We already had one, according to you.
I want to give him crap for it, so I count that.
Okay. Ooh, got a read on the nothing in the air, but didn't do anything with it, so just double nothing. 2 wrongs don't make a right, Murr. Come on, Andrew. Ooh, gets the down air.
Confirmed down throw? Up air. Too high. He used all his jumps. Frame 5.
Frame 5!
Can't handle that. What are you going to do?
Ooh, soft falling Nair is so good. And strong falling Nair. Actually, falling Nair is just super good. Let's just be real.
Dude, not charged blood is pitiful.
It's so sad.
It's like a broken, like, sprinkler.
It's like somebody just going...
Yeah, it's like raspberrying at people. It's like,
It's like when your water pressure's not right.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like you try to take a shower, but it's just kind of falling on your frame 5. Actually, that's a 2 frame 5 because you got him with the back hit.
Oh, that's 2 frame 5, though. I just know first hit. I don't remember.
Back throw!
That's it.
Stock for Murr!
Getting that back throw kill on the first try this time on this game. No 18 back throws for him. Oh, there we go. He knows. He knows about the jumps. He's getting those up airs.
I've always thought that the most hype thing to do would be, like, at a big crew battle to be, like, the MC. So you could be, like... And for UNT, Andrew Murr-Barstow!
We should do that next time.
That would be so cool.
That'd be awesome.
I'd love to be the MC for that. That sounds so cool.
I know.
4 throw?
Ooh, there we go.
Yeah.
I was talking with the OU guys, just having like a little tiny, just collegiate crew battle happen at like OU sometime next semester. Just have people come out, have a good time.
Yeah.
Maybe fun.
Got the balloon and the combo. That's what I'm talking about.
Dude, he does SD that stock now. He earned it. You just give up. He earned that stock. Give it to him.
Well, I like what Texan Sniper did, because when you use the Guardian Orbitars, your aerial drift does increase. So he used that to just slide right to the, what's it called? The ledge. That's what it's called.
Oh, was he trying to catch him with that? That would have been cool.
I think so, yeah.
Oh, his Murr's being in his face the whole time. Because that's a lot how Pit likes to play, is he has to be up in your face because he wants to get throw combos, he wants to hit you with these aerials. Mario's like, I'm already in your face, man. I'm going to take the lead. What? All these clanks.
Yeah.
All right, Murr. I know you know how to up smash, man.
Hit the up smash button. I play Mario 2, and I also have this problem. He doesn't want to go up for the edge guard. Go up for the edge guard. Yeah. Mario's so good at edge guarding.
It's like, it's a crew battle. He's at a high percent. He knows he's going to take the stock. I'll give him the benefit. That's a stock.
Shielding the frame 6, and the back throw will do it. So Murr, pretty regular on this second stock.
Up throw. Down air.
Ooh, went through the forward air. That's the that is the sickest dunk, frame 5.
Oh man.
But that's a time to go for an edge guard right there when you have that last stock going. Yeah, Texas Cypher really just able to just get back with these recoveries.
I mean, pitch recovery.
He got the balloon.
Oh my god. These balloon battles are sick. Oh, the pitch recovery is predictable, but it's also just one of those where it's like, I think I can drop down and get it, but then they ledge snap, and you're like, okay, that was wasting my time.
Yeah.
He's playing it safe. He doesn't want an SD. He doesn't want to give up free stocks. I think he's doing a good job.
Oop. That could have... I think down smash might have almost killed. Don't think it would have killed, but it would have been close. Oh, using the flood to just the really annoy him in general.
I thought he just gave up for a second. I was going to be sad. That's not going to kill yet.
No,
man.
It's not going to kill yet.
Throw him at the club. Tell him his ID does not work. Don't come in with fake IDs, kids. We know.
It's a matter of caring.
Just up smash. Don't up tilt. Frame up smash. Run up smash. Run up smash. Mario, what are you doing? What is that up tilt?
Maybe that was a misinputed up smash.
Maybe.
Frame 5.
I'll have a long talk with Murr after this and ask him why he never up smashes.
I'm going to ask him too.
Because he'd be doing real well if he could.
Yeah. Literally, like, the ally hand warmer was just, hang on, let me do a hand warmer, and then he up smashed twice and said, all right, I'm ready.
Ally's a super fun guy to be around. Yeah. Up smash, catch
up smash,
it up.
Got it.
Take a page out of Texan Sniper's book, Murr.
Just do an up smash, Murr.
Just do one. One up smash.
He just wants to get the kills with the back
throw. Back throw, yeah.
Frame 5. Frame 5. Frame 5. Hey, guess what?
That wasn't one. Thankfully.
I was just going to wait. Up air does it. Which, if he killed with up air, he probably could have killed with up smash.
Yeah, like 50% earlier, yeah.
Yeah.
Murr stays in.
Murr stays in, yeah.
Only to annoy me by not up smashing once more.
Well, he's taking 4 stocks. He's going to see if he can take 5.
He's taking 4. I thought he took more.
He took 1, right? Off of... Or did he take...
It's
2.
Crazy how we just saw all this and we don't remember what just happened.
Dude, my short-term memory is the worst.
We were so focused on what's happening in front of us that we lose track.
Yeah.
Unfortunate. He's taking good stocks, though. Murr is doing so good that Denti and Jace might not even get to play.
I don't think 4 is correct. I think 7 is correct for UNT. Because we still have Jace and Denti and 1 stock of Murr's.
I think you meant to put the 4 on the other side.
Oh, okay.
It was like 3. I don't know.
No, it would be 3 on the other side.
Yeah,
UNT has 7 stocks left.
Let's go.
Texas A&M with 3. We're going to see the DDD. We saw them cheering for him when he was playing against Elrox, I believe. It is 7 for UNT.
It's 7.
No, it's right.
Oh,
we
right.
Still have Denti, Jace, and 1 stock of Murr.
Yeah, because Jace hasn't played.
Billy,
dang,
with the
Billy.
Greatest burp I have heard in weeks.
I don't think they can hear that on the stream.
No,
so
they can't.
That was just for me and you. They can? Oh, they
cannot.
Can't. All right.
So UNT has a single DDD named...
Is it Captain Birdman?
So we have 2.
Does he play DDD in this game?
I don't think of Captain Birdman as a DDD player because he doesn't really play this game. Yeah. But I was thinking of somebody named the Highwayman. Who is
Highwayman.
Highwayman, yeah.
What a good name.
Eccentric, and I love it. And he is actually not that bad. He usually gets just outside of top 8 at our tournaments.
Not bad.
So, yeah, he's pretty good. But we'll see if Murr can remember how to deal with DDD. This is an awkward matchup for anybody, as DDD is very difficult to kill. Let's see. Got the up tilt.
Now, you know what would be a really good kill move right now?
It's an up smash.
It's up smash, yes.
Well, up smash won't kill DDD yet, actually.
Nah, you're right. 10 Ooh. More percent, though.
10 more percent, Nate will, yeah. If he gets the back hit, not the forward hit.
Dude, this Gordo.
Yeah, he's having a tough time getting around it. Hey, those are 10%.
All right. Just stand up smash. Why?
Okay, forward throw.
You know, for a guy who doesn't go off stage for edge guard, he likes to edge guard a lot.
Ooh. And is that the up smash? No.
He's doing a bunch of aerials and never up smashing.
Oh, I thought he was going to go for the dunk. I thought he was going to say to him, let's go for a dunk.
Dunkin' Donuts, man.
And still refusing to up smash.
Oh, jeez. Barely dodging under Gordo there.
Barely.
I hate you.
I don't.
Stop.
I'm just kidding.
You're the worst. Pivot grab, that's it.
Back throw. We'll do it.
All right. Murr is not taking a single stock with up smash yet. And I'm very disappointed.
Taking five stocks, none with up smash. That's actually quite impressive. Rolling at just the right time to get under that. And it's just kind of lying down a little bit. Mexidu playing EDD. He says right now, I'm going to take that stock from that damn Mario. Ooh!
Not
going to kill, but it was pretty sick.
If that killed, that would have been funny. I mean, I would laugh so hard.
Ooh, back air. Hefty.
DDD is hefty.
He is certainly not wimpy. That forward air will take it.
Do you think that they're going to end up putting in Jace instead?
I think they might put in Jace just to take down that stock. They're putting in Jace. And I think the reasoning behind this is that definitely from my experience, Jace is not great under pressure.
Okay, so you don't want to be your anchor, in theory.
No, not an anchor at all.
He's very good,
but under pressure, I think he's good as a two or a three in a crew battle.
Also, so he's probably going to be playing Bayonetta again, I'd assume.
Probably.
So if he's going with Bayonetta, then against the big body, that's pretty solid stuff.
Yeah. Dude, Nintendo has to release a voice pack for DDD that is the right back at your voice.
That voice is amazing.
I'm going to kick that Bayonetta's butt.
That'd be so
funny. Gonna clobber her like that there Kirby.
I miss Waddle Dees, man. I miss being able to throw Waddle Dees. Waddle Dees were funny.
That's the way to start a crew battle with DDD, by the way.
I agree. Oh, man, 1%.
That's important.
That's a good lead.
So we'll see how Jace remembers to deal with the DDD matchup.
Well, I mean, I sure you do stuff like that. You do that.
Okay. So he tried to escape with up B, I think, and didn't happen.
All right. So he's already got 62%. That's like Bayonetta versus Heavy.
Oh, the SD.
Mexiju, please no. You know what's bad? Okay, so after this, A&M still got to play OU.
Mm-hmm.
And if they come off a rough loss to UNT, and they watched OU beat UNT, it's not looking good
for them.
Okay,
brag about it, why don't you?
I will. All day. OU is crazy.
But hey, according to you guys, it doesn't count.
It doesn't.
Exactly. Is Jace about to get this? Jace!
Oh my god.
Just took two clean stocks.
That was rough stuff.
And with six stocks to spare, UNT over A&M.
That actually physically hurt me to watch.
Not for me.
No. Not because UNT won, but because Mexiju, team captain, goes in, anchor. And
SDs,
then two quick ones, SD followed by just a sick combo.
That is
like,
actually pretty sad.
That is unfortunate.